maybe he's coming into this thinking he's the clear favorite and he won't want to reveal any unique strategies prior to the finals.
Ooh, I think there's too much on the line there. Finals will be extremely long. So most of the time, the longer the set, the better player wins, because if you prepared one single strategy, it will be less relevant in the grand scheme. So I think he will show everything here. And we will see Liereyy going for Haboob and winged very aggressive maps by him. Villese likes to mix in some water.
Yeah, and this is the kind of map draft I would have predicted before. Villese, you know, with maps that are maybe a little bit farther apart, have that water element, the sort of hybrid feel, and then Liereyy with Haboob, which is so close and so crazy, and then Winged, which is even closer and even crazier, and both being land maps somewhere where Liereyy really, really shines. Looking at the Civ draft, Liereyy going for maybe some more standard picks, and Villese, I see the Byzantines there again. He picked that yesterday, and I see the Mayans, a Civ that only Doubt has picked so far in this tournament.
Mm-hmm. And not very successfully, as we saw yesterday there, but that also was against Vikings and heavily outcountered strategy-wise. Something to mention is that we will likely see a replay there. When it comes to how Cattails is going to play out, Liereyy not really drafting for Fire Galley Civilization, so he will likely play Saracens with some galleys against the Byzantines. Saracens of Galley Liereyy and Fire Galleys from Villese. They're playing the Byzantines, so two different approaches on one of Villese's home map.
Yeah, and you have to feel like Byzantines maybe a little bit stronger there, but it's really, really close with the Saracens. Hera failed with the Saracens against Liereyy on that map yesterday. Liereyy, of course, playing as the Celts, which was kind of an unexpected pick on his part. Looking at the bans, we have a Vikings ban from Villese, and then we have a Magyars ban from Liereyy. So both banning pretty typical, very strong Empire Wars civs that maybe could be used on any map, and that means that the Arabia starter is going to be a matchup that maybe we haven't seen before.
Not unlikely. Well, Vikings, Mayans not really an option, and if we think about Huns, probably Kevasan, Byzantines, Cattails, and then we have really aggressive Winged and Haboob, not unlikely to see Aztecs there. So likely that Slavs or Malians, maybe even Mayans, are going to be picked on Arabia there for Villese.
Yeah, I can't see that Mayans pick being useful anywhere else, can you?
Depends a bit. What is he expecting of Liereyy to be played on Arabia? We have seen him play Ethiopians quite a bit, although he was stopped by Eagles yesterday. And Aztec still an option for Villese.
Yeah, Aztecs being very, very strong. I think we saw the stats page with their win rate, and it was surprisingly high for the amount of low picks that it has. It seems that players aren't too confident picking Aztecs in the Empire War format, but when they do, and when they have their confidence behind it, they can carry that to a victory. Huns for Villese, once again on Kawasan. We've seen a lot of Hun picks there. We saw him go, if I remember correctly, went for Cav Archers against Viper yesterday on Kawasan. Mm-hmm.
Doubt and Villese with the same approach there. Four Archer Rangers, mass Cav Archers. And Villese even in the interview gave credit like that Doubt apparently was the inventor of that approach. And he looked really strong. Again, he might face Franks.
Yeah, the same Civ matchup we've seen. Well, we saw that Yo against Doubt, I believe we saw that. We saw that Viper against Villese. We saw that matchup Hera versus Liereyy, although Hera didn't opt to go for the Cav Archers. So pretty standard stuff there for Kawasan. Winged, I think we'll see Bulgarians being picked from Liereyy. What do you expect from Villese?
It's not easy for me to judge. I think I wouldn't mind a Mesocivilization, but then again, Incas could have been something if he wanted to go for a Mesocivilization. So I think he might even go for Malians.
Yeah, Malians seems like a pretty strong pick there. Although we've seen Bulgarians, once they get that early pressure and early damage in, it kind of spirals out of control a little bit for them. So might be tough there with the Malians to get something going against the Bulgarians. We'll see. Winged is such a crazy map with the gold in the center and all those open wood lines. As soon as one army is in, you can find your eco being harassed at five different places. Definitely a map that is tailored towards Liereyy's skill set for sure, with the amount of micromanagement that he brings to the game. I want to talk about this a little bit because our community in the past maybe 5 years, as we've grown with viewer counts, people have been saying that it's a little bit stagnant in the pro scene. There's only so many pro players, and it seems like we keep seeing the same top players over and over and over and over again. And this tournament has really put that to rest. I mean, we have Doubt, ACCM, Villese in a top four, three players that we really usually wouldn't expect to see even advance to a top eight situation. How do you think Empire Wars has impacted our pro scene? And do you think if we continue to have these Empire Wars tournaments, are we going to see similar upsets like this? Or are the regular guys who are great at RM tournaments going to rise to the top again?
Well, I think King of the Desert already showed quite some upsets, right? So I don't actually put it too much on Empire Wars. The Empire Wars mixed it a bit more because the Red Bull format is so fast paced, and we see best of threes, we see best of five qualifiers over 2 days, and if you have one bad day, you won't make it into the main event. Therefore, the format sets you up a bit more for upsets. And well, you can only win if you have the small advantage and have to go through long qualifiers. Even if you're a 75-25 format, in the old days we had endless amount of restarts, like the tournaments dragged out for weeks and months, and like double elimination, yada yada. So it was pretty easy to come back. This time, single elimination, unforgiving. We did see that one before. Something I quickly want to mention while we look at the draft. Change there on the Spanish end of the Red Bull today. They will cast on the official Spanish Red Bull channel, twitch.tv/RedBullES. For everyone who was watching it on other streams, you're very welcome over there. Link in the Twitch chat if you feel like watching it in Spanish.
Shouldn't you have said that in Spanish?
Por favor, Monsieur et Madame, allez à la Twitch stream de Twitch España, por favor.
That's exactly what I was hoping would happen.
This is international, right?
Yeah, and we are about to get into game number one. It's going to be Arabia, of course. This is a best of five semi-final between Villese and Liereyy, and I can see the civs already, Nilly. It is going to be Ethiopians matching up against the Aztecs from Villese.
Mm-hmm. And, well, basically, Villese got a soft cheat served yesterday. How to beat Liereyy with Aztecs against Liereyy's Ethiopians on Arabia. Villese just needs to play the same like Hera did yesterday. That easy.
You say that as if it's super easy. I mean, Hera did a great job defending yesterday, building up his eagles, and then not losing too much against Liereyy's early push. But he certainly showed a way to counter Ethiopian archers, which is just don't engage with the eagles. Wait until you get to Imperial Age and then force a big fight immediately against that Ethiopian player. We'll see if Villese can pull something similar here. We'll see if he can survive until the Imperial Age. We know the pressure from Liereyy is oftentimes just smothering and overwhelming. And we'll see if Liereyy can pull that off here in game number one. We should be in soon, folks. Thank you for showing up to day number five of Red Bull Wololo. We've got two exciting semifinals yet to come, and the finals, which we're all looking forward to. Here we go, Nilly.
It is Liereyy, the defending champion, against a guy that went through the qualifier to be now in the semifinals, beating the Viper yesterday, Villese in the yellow trunks.
Yeah, Villese has really, really shown his quality throughout this tournament, and he's opening with a second barracks with the Aztecs here, Nilly, and it kind of looks like he's thinking about walling up early. You can see that villager over on the right making a preemptive palisade wall. Is Liereyy going to scout this? Nobody sees the second barracks.
Oh yeah, really important. And now the big question is, will he switch his approach to yesterday? He simply played mass crossbows into Arbalest. Do you think maybe a different approach could be more successful today?
Normally, I'd say you want to switch up your strategy if your opponent has seen you go for something similar before, as Villese gets some free hits on that scout. Liereyy pulls it away, though. But some strategies, Nilly, are just so strong, you have to play them and force your opponent to adapt and to beat it. And I think Liereyy, with a big ball of crossbows and or arbalists, is very, very tough to stop. So I think he's going to go for the massing of the archers again. I'll be interested to see whether he adds in some knights like he did yesterday, as Villese might be able to catch these archers off guard.
Microing back there. He has fletching. I'm really confused that we see two spearmen mixed in there. That's such an odd choice, in my opinion.
Yeah, it is. It is a weird choice from Liereyy there, but maybe he just wanted a few extra units to get in the way. Look at this, Nilly, those archers, he saved them for so long, got some great hits on the eagles, and you know, the spearmen, they just got in front of the archers and delayed the eagles from attacking, and Liereyy takes a decent trade there. I think one archer lost for him, and what, four eagles lost for Villese?
Indeed. -2 KD for losses for him. And look at the resources already, Dave. Liereyy will be up to castle edge at a very quick timing. Only played one archer range.
Yeah, he's got the first wood upgrade, but he doesn't have the farm upgrade yet. He's not going to spend that until he clicks up to the castle edge. And he put enough pressure down to dwindle the numbers a little bit, the early numbers from Villese, to get his walls completed. You can see he's just finishing up on the right. Villese is going to shift over to the front side just as Liereyy secures that main gold and has some archers waiting there in defense.
I think this will not be broken. Enough villagers pulled there, the hill advantage as well. Now the big question is, how is Villese trying to increase his castle edge timing? Already sold 100 stone? Wouldn't be surprised if he sells another 100.
Yeah, maybe. And that'll give us a good indication of what he wants his strategy to be. Obviously, if you sell 200 stone, you're not really planning on placing TC's early castle age. You're going to have to go and mine stone, which he's doing right now. So maybe he's giving himself some options here, Nilly. If he reads the situation and he feels like a third barracks is needed, he can go for that. But if he reads that Liereyy is fully walled and there's nowhere he can pressure, maybe he goes for that second, that third TC.
Selling stone, buying some food for himself, now sends two villagers onto stone. Interesting approach, kind of exposed if he ever loses map control, but only has a gate at the front. Liereyy plays this one really defensively, now adds a stable. Change to yesterday.
No, he did add knights yesterday against the eagles from Hera. He did add knights fairly early. So it seems very similar, but he's adding a second stable now, Nilly. So this is different from yesterday. And Villese, I noticed he has 11 on gold right now, so probably not thinking about staying on just two barracks production. Probably thinking about adding a third one sometime soon.
At 6 production, luckily for him, faster than with the other eagle civilizations. They're now going for all the upgrades. That will be a lot of pressure. We need to see another house behind this gate. Gates die very quickly to this army.
Yeah, either house behind this gate or Les needs to bring his army back and kind of debate that army away. I don't know if Liereyy will fall for that. The house is behind the gate. The gate is going to go down extremely fast. The eagles are inactive and a market wall attempted, but Leary's in. And this is big time trouble for Villese, not the start he wanted.
Oh, one villager should die here. Liereyy should. No, he's not. He's trying to dive. No, will think better of it. Has to be happy with all the reactions he forced. But Villese, not too many losses.
Yeah, not too many losses. He actually walled on the left-hand side really, really early as if he foresaw this coming. And then walled next to the TC to prevent Liereyy from diving. But there is a hole there. The knights have made their way through with the pikemen, and the crossbow are also going that way. Villese does have an army behind, but he needs to wait for the upgrades. Does he have enough time?
20 seconds. Well, lots of idle villagers forced there, as we can see in the column at the absolute right. Even though it needs to pull villagers away from the gold, that's so unfortunate for him. Liereyy with a lot of pressure. Look at all those villagers not really knowing what to do.
Yeah, and Villese is just waiting for this army to move along before he ungarrisons them back to the gold. He's forced to run with his woodline as well, and those knights are going to do so much work in this situation. You want to take out the crossbow numbers, but the knights are going to be a nice buffer in between the eagles and the crossbows. Liereyy's getting on the hill now.
Could even make an argument for going for the crossbow instead of the knights because they don't scale too well. As you can see, army in shambles. Did rewall the top quite nicely. The engagement looks good for Villese, but so much investment, so much idle time. Liereyy won't mind this.
Yeah, and Liereyy probably knew as soon as he went in through the front of the base, he was going to lose that army. So he just wanted to buy as much time as possible, get as much value from that. Villese does clear that up, though, and he's got continuous two barracks production for his eagles. So he's going to shift his pressure forward a little bit. Behind this, Liereyy has added a second TC, and now he's sending more knights over to try and pressure the walls.
Also, he's sending more villagers over to stone. So Shotels could be an option, and Shotel Warriors are incredibly good against eagles. Massive damage output from them.
Yeah, I want to know if Liereyy shifts now into more crossbow production, because he's kept up the production from two stables as he sends three more knights in, and he'll be able to kill a couple villagers here on the stone. But I want to see him start building up the crossbow numbers. Does Villese patch that hole? He does. Nice job by Villese.
Important. Those three knights could have gotten some kills, especially with forging. Just so much better at killing villagers. Knights now diving under the TC. Quite an interesting choice, but I don't see too many eagles dealing with that.
The thing for Liereyy, I think he's looking at these knights like, I'm not building up towards a large knight army. They're just a unit that I'm going to use to delay and do as much eco damage as possible. So he's willing to dive, willing to take those extra couple of hits under the TC as long as he gets some villager kills or eagle kills, which he's getting right now.
Yeah, he won't mind that. Is 11 villagers ahead, 8 crossbows now, 17 eagles. Starting to look like a scary number, but he can't really pressure without a forward siege workshop.
Yeah, I think this is a moment here where Villese needs to consider going for some sort of 1 TC all-in push, because he knows his economy is so far behind. He hasn't even been in Liereyy's base yet this game. He knows he needs to do damage, and with Aztecs, it's a pretty simple ramp-up for them. You add a few more on gold, you add a few more barracks, maybe you add a monastery or siege workshop and try and pressure in Castle Age. He's going for with the eagles to see what damage that can be done, but he can't take the fight.
And look how different approach Liereyy is going for. And I said it yesterday. If we compare that to the ACCM Winchester game, where the early crossbows did a lot of damage of Winchester as well, and he continued to go for aggression after aggression, Liereyy knows my economy is good. I just need to keep my TCs running, keep up the production, and my advantage will increase even further.
Yeah, he knows all the damage he's done to Villese, and he had full scouting on Villese's economy nearly. So he knows there's not like two random TCs hiding. As Villese actually goes for two extra TCs, that's a surprising move for me.
Yeah, 17 villagers behind, trying to play catch up there. Liereyy sends a knight out, more probably expecting a siege workshop, does not see it, and well, he will be a bit confused what's coming, sees more eagles, and yeah, moves back even a bit further. Does not want to eat any conversions.
Yeah, conversions could come in big in these fights. If Villese has a couple monks, He gets two knights on his side. That's minus two knights for Liereyy, and then all it takes is a bad engagement against the eagles, and suddenly your crossbow numbers are gone. Liereyy has to be careful here not to be too aggressive going forward into Liereyy's area.
And Liereyy even feels like he can move out, dives for the Mongs, and now takes the engagement. A tricky one with 20 village elite.
Yeah, he's got to get the crossbows in the right position and the knights in front. He's trying to get them up on the hill. The knights are engaging. There's monks behind, though, Nilly.
It's an odd choice there by Liereyy going for it. The monks, no more phase on them, but the army was simply good enough. Liereyy with that beautiful hill for the crossbows. So close to the fight, but still doing damage. Now 5 military to 20. Liereyy just rufflestomped this army.
Yeah, Liereyy. Nilly. I was about to call him Nilly again. Liereyy crushed that army, the power of the knights, and going double stable. What a strategy to counter the Aztecs, and Villese has no answer for that. Game number one, convincingly to Liereyy here. What do you think Villese could have done differently?
Just the front wall was the big problem there. He needed to buy some more time. Eagles get such a big power spike getting to Eagle Warriors. You produce faster, 3 more attack for yourself, more HP, more armor, all the benefits, and fighting before that is not an option. Therefore, you need to be walled, get your upgrades, then take the engagement. Villese had to run quite a bit. Walls could have bought him that time.
Yeah, it felt weird, right? Because he walled off the left-hand side with houses behind his one palisade wall. It's almost as if he didn't expect Liereyy to just knock at the front door and go right through that gate. But through the gate he went, idled Villese's entire economy, and then, you know, kind of built up his military behind once he lost the first engagement. And when he saw the army from Villese in the middle coming forward for a fight, he happily took it and carried it forward to the front of Villese's base. Villese will need a response here in game number two as we go to the statistics screen. Pretty short game, so maybe not too much to see here, but I expect to see an economic advantage for Liereyy.
Yeah, should be there. Only 18-minute game. Liereyy with the better KD obviously did kill those eagles quite nicely, did kill the house earlier. And the economy will tell us that Liereyy was in full control. Even gold, that's something we don't see too often. Those are numbers.
Yeah, it's not even an even number. 3661 gold collected for both players. That's kind of nice to see. The villager high firmly in Liereyy's favor. And then if we skip to the timeline, we can see the moment at the end there where that big fight was. A steep decline for Villese, and he figured there was no way back. Liereyy showing his dominance there in game number one, Arabia. And is Villese going to struggle against this aggressive approach? I mean, we saw a more passive approach from Viper yesterday, maybe a more boomy style, maybe not suited to Empire Wars. Liereyy, we're going to see tons of early aggression. Do you think that works against Villese? Do you think he can adapt to that?
I think he should know what Liereyy is up to. I think that was one walling mistake. Just stop thinking about that game, jump into the next one. I don't think we really saw how this set is going to play out. Otherwise, we would be in for a very short one.
All right, we should be able to get into the game soon here. We're going into game number two, and I'm being told that the map is Cattails, Villese's home map. So we were predicting Byzantines against Saracens. We're into the game now, and that indeed is the civilization choice for both players. Villese in the north and Liereyy in the south here.
Kind of what we expected, and this will be different approaches. Galley approach from Mr. Liereyy, most likely fire galley from Villese. 1v1, a fire galley is so much better than a galley, but if you get to those 6-8 galleys and can micro them, then they should do pretty well against fire galleys.
Yeah, it all depends on the micro. We saw it yesterday from Liereyy against Hera, and his micro was on point, so we'll see if he can keep this up here. Immediately going forward with galleys, sniping a fishing ship from Villese, and continuing to harass there as Villese is trying to respond with a fire galley of his own on the fishing economy from Liereyy.
Galley is so good against fishing ships, only need 6 hits to find the kill there, and we can see Liereyy microing a bit, now gets to more galleys. Nice quick ball by Villese.
Did Villese just delete the house to get out of that bind away from the scout with that villager? That was very, very strange. He had palisade walls next to there. But anyway, he's pushing back the galleys with his own fire galley, but the galleys now to a mount where he's got to be very, very careful. Once Liereyy gets 6 or 7 galleys on the water, they can micro these fires pretty efficiently.
Yeah, not the greatest micro there. We did see that one dock was idle for quite some time. Fishing ships now really low in HP. KD 4-1. Can he save those fishing ships? Yes, he can!
Yeah, fishing ships at like 1 HP, but I'm sure Villese will send his reinforcements around to try and snipe those at some point. Liereyy exploring the economy from Villese. I don't know what sort of scouting Villese has on Liereyy, but Liereyy has a pretty good grasp on where all the resources are at Villese's base if he decides to go for some land pressure. Right now, he's happily sitting on the middle water with a bunch of galleys. Yeah, we can see Villese only seeing the dock from Liereyy currently.
Galley's now coming over. We see the heavy market usage from Liereyy. Another advantage there for Saracens. And sniping some has to be happy with that one. But fishing ship losses of his own on his side.
Yeah, kind of both players off of the fishing economy right now. Liereyy only with 2 left. Although I believe he maybe thinking about adding another fishing ship, because I don't see the production really from him from his docks.
Well, I think he did just add one. Had 2 fire galley losses, so did add one. Interesting choice. Feels like he won water significantly enough. Adds a 4th one even. Lovely, greedy play by Liereyy.
Yeah, and he's going to camp the docks to make sure there's no further fire ships coming out, but Villese sneaking around with a villager. So Liereyy maybe with the correct decision here to go for some extra fishing ships, sensing that Villese would go for some land pressure early and wouldn't be producing more water units to push back.
Really good control here from Liereyy. He did add the barracks himself. Now is stable, if I saw that one correctly. And Villese, still no buildings at the right-hand side. That will still take some time. Also, now clicking up to Castle Age, a solid 2 minutes behind.
Yeah, Liereyy in control once again. Villese does have some numbers, though, in those docks. He's got a couple fire galleys in each, and if he manages to get up to the Castle Age before the docks go down, he could potentially upgrade them, and then Liereyy will have to invest more resources to keep the water safe. I'm curious to what Villese goes for here. Do you go for a stable, or do you go for an archer range, or multiple archer ranges behind?
Since he is not building anything yet, I think the play might even be Monastery and Siege Workshop, but then I would love to see more than one villager. He goes for the stable first.
Yeah, going for the stable. Byzantine Knights, maybe not the best in the game, but early Castle Age, they can still do a ton of damage, especially with a extremely open economy such as Liereyy's. Liereyy desperately trying to hunt down these fire ships before they loop around to his fish, but Villese pops out more at the docks. Liereyy doesn't notice immediately, loses a galley, and now Villese, you know, making a case for himself on this middle water.
First demo being added, tries to defend there. Fire galley needs to micro, lots of hits for Villese. He won't mind this.
No, he's getting some good hits here, and this is the problem with galleys versus fire ships. Fire ships, very, very easy to micro. You know, you just kind of patrol them in against the galleys or maybe get some good positioning behind. Galleys, on the other hand, constant attention needs to be paid to them. So if you're caught off guard, you could lose your numbers pretty quickly. And especially once Villese gets that fire ship upgrade, they become so much harder to kill.
And we see Liereyy not focusing on that one. Will decimate the fire galley numbers before they can upgrade to fire ships, though. I think some market usage could be on the card. And now he clicks Botkin first before The war galley upgrade. Uh-oh, first night in the woodland.
First night in the woodland, and Liri went for a monastery, probably in somewhat in defense, expecting the knights. He's going to lose the villager building that, but the monastery does go up, luckily for him. I would have liked to see Villese build up a few knights before he comes in with this raid, rather than just one, although he's doing quite a bit of damage here.
Liri failing with the quick walls, but he's attacking with his knights at the other side now as well. So that will be some return favor while there's so much going on the water. Oh god, this is triple pronged action now.
Yeah, Villese's base looks a lot more secure though than Liri's. Liri's was very open as Villese comes in with those fire ships. And Villese quick walling around the TC. He already pre-walled his woodline. He's killing so many villagers on Liri's woodline.
Oh, full disaster there. Even walled in the monk. Nice. Job should continue with the conversion indeed. Likely to kill one knight. Liri's macro not on point, or is he? What? He killed the monk! That should have never happened!
Yeah, that. Oh boy. Les should have gotten a conversion there. Blame the RNG for not getting one, or hop that monk in the TC. But right now, Liri is doing the damage at Bless's economy, killing a couple villagers of his own. Bless has more monks on the field, gets a conversion, and he should be able to hold this off for now.
Liri, two workers ahead, some military ahead. Scout is finding a good kill against the scout.
Scout killing two monks. Yeah, killing two monks there, and that's a great addition from Villese to wipe up those monks. That's 200 gold investment there from Liri, and Villese counters that with only one scout. He's also killing the fishing ships from Liri with some sneaky fires. It's very difficult to manage your fishing economy in Castle Age when you're trying to pressure on land. He's trying to defend them with just war galleys against sneaky fire ships is extremely difficult. I see Villese going for a second TC now, nearly. Third TC as well.
Interesting. So feels like, okay, he did a lot of damage, wants to play the long game. And yesterday we saw Saracens can get to a really strong composition, but Byzantines, a master in late imp, especially if gold runs out.
And of course, they go up to Imperial Age cheaper, so you can even get there much faster than your opponent. Do you think Liri should be using these units at his base to scout for that sneak villager? Or do you think he assumes that Bless, like him, has a stable near his base and is just sending knights in small groups towards his economy?
Well, it was one single knight. It was kind of late. And maybe that makes him believe that it's a stable at home. But he didn't scout the stable. So I wouldn't mind to see an outpost right-hand side, outpost left-hand side. But he's not on stone. So maybe a scout could even make sense.
Yeah, perhaps. Great walls from Villese to prevent those knights and camels from getting in. His economy, though, still a little bit open with some opportunities for Liri to raid. Villese is actually sending camels back in defense.
Oh, I don't mind camel defense while knights are attacking. Really good against villagers, as we all know. Camel defense here for Liri seems to be saving that villager quite nicely. Villager count, 5 in an advantage here for Liri. And just seems like he has way more control everywhere right now.
Yeah, he's definitely dictating the pace of the game. Those 5 villagers, though, Nilly, are the fishing ships on the middle.
Okay. Well, I won't mind those. Obviously, become less efficient in the long run. Probably does not have gill net, so semi-efficient there. But 3 TC is rolling, and Liri's imp macro is just so good, as we saw yesterday.
Yeah, and both players going out to collect the relics. I think both of them know this game might go quite long. A lot of games on this map or similar maps like Baltic or Mediterranean usually end up in a kind of stalemate situation. So it's a great thing to grab the relics early and deny that from your opponent. Harry's actually guarding the one at the north. No, he doesn't see it. Never mind. He's just casually sitting there with a knight.
Yeah, line of sight of knights, not that great. That's one of the unappreciated bonuses of Franks, actually, that they see a bit more. That's why they can raid a bit better. Sees another relic there. Relic counter, third column to the right at the bottom. One for each player right now. Still running around a bit. And action calmed down a bit. Both players setting themselves up for it.
Yeah, and I love Liereyy's position here because he's adding extra docks and he's adding more fishing ships, Nilly. So he fought for that water and he's going to use it to his advantage, which, to be honest, we haven't seen a whole lot on this map so far. Usually when players win the water, they just keep the three or four fishing ships that they had remaining fishing there. They don't add extras, and Liereyy has chosen to do that, which means his food eco is going to be far ahead of Villese's.
What are the next steps here? Both players will be up to him pretty soon. And then what do you see as ideal army compositions from both players?
Well, it's going to depend a lot on what your opponent's making, right? If you're Saracens, it feels like you want to go into Herbalist, but like against Byzantines feels tough. And then if you're Byzantines, are you just waiting to see what your opponent goes for and then you go for the counter? It's weird.
Yeah, but then again, if you just build all the buildings and not really building any army, suddenly 30 Arbalests arrive from a Saracen player. You didn't scout it and he just kills all your TCs, all your buildings. Not too pretty either. It feels though, yeah, mixed army composition. Something like Hussar Arbalest against Halberdier, Elite Skirmisher. Something that Villese could play longer. No. Look at the map exploration for Liereyy. Great, great job. Finds another relic for himself. Should be 3v2.
Yeah, and we saw this yesterday. Remember all the outposts he had against Hera? It was nuts. And he's almost got 100% map exploration. We're only 21 minutes into the game. That's fantastic play from Liereyy to get all that knowledge. He knows this game will most likely go late, so he can use that to his advantage. Both players now teching into Arbalest. Villese with army on the left, and Liereyy with army on the right.
Neither player really on stone this game. No one going for any castles. Very untypical on the map that could be very stalemate at some sites. What do you think could be the reason for that?
I don't really know, Nilly.
Ooh, nice quick wall to... Chopped him over the wall there. Thank you, DE. Monk coming over for the defense. And, well, crossbows is the unit choice here for Villese. Certainly will need some buffer in front of that if Liereyy decides to go for Hussars.
Yeah, and Liereyy is walling up on the left-hand side here, Nilly, exactly where Villese was thinking about pushing. So Villese is going to be stalled out from doing damage, and Liereyy will have the momentum hitting into early imp here as he's sending a ram and his crossbow, soon to be Arbalest, forward to Villese's economy, and Villese's army is out of position.
Okay, no ballistics here, so Wargally's not doing too much. Uh-oh, those crossbows sneaking through again, and they will find some kills. Oh, for some idle time. And now the quick question is, what is Villese doing? He's still trying to continue with his aggression at the bottom, but running into stone walls.
Yeah, I think he just assumed that it would be open over there. He's still producing knights, so he's harassing Liereyy's gold a little bit, but he's not going to kill as many villagers as Liereyy is going to kill here soon if Villese doesn't respond. He's up against stone walls on the left. Kind of feels like you need to bring your army back and counter this raid.
He's going to mix in some skirmishers, has 5 elite skirmishers on the field now. Liereyy still without ballistics, tries to squeeze in chemistry before that.
Yeah, you wonder how many villagers he would have killed if he had ballistics. Unfortunately, that villager runs into her friend and bounces her back into the shot, so Liereyy gets a few more kills here.
Uh-oh, what are those villagers up to? Oh, the woodline went dry at the top, and now those villagers are going to the next tree. What is happening here?
Oh, that's a disaster. Oh, no. Oh, the game decides to stack itself against Villese as he loses 10 villagers who were going for a straggler tree.
Oh, woodland running out there. So unfortunate. Liereyy now taking the hill there. Has to be happy with camping that hill. Elite skirmishers will clear it up eventually. But honestly, 30 population lead and Liereyy just continues to swarm in.
It felt doable until that moment for Villese. Like, he was behind, sure, but it felt like he could make a comeback, and then the AI of the game decides to throw him for a loop and send the villagers right into the forward army. Villagers battering down Rams on the right-hand side. He's going to clear up the Arbalest, but just have to ask yourself, like, 20-plus villagers behind, how does he make a comeback here?
Even Converts a Villager could go for the repair there. A bit too late, but the TC is still in some danger, and Villese broke through the left-hand side and now goes like, let's attack, kill villagers! Or not.
Maybe hop in the ram. Maybe hop in the ram. Get safe there as he loses the majority of his Arbalest army. And there's another wall behind Nilly. Everything is going wrong for Villese here. Excellent play from Liereyy. I think we're going to a game number three pretty soon.
Feels like a 20 population lead though only. We were at 30 at one point. Villese still pushing there and Liereyy going for some smaller defense. Actually not that much land army right now for Liereyy. Look at that. 10 Arbalest, 3 Monks, 2 Camels, 1 Knight. Doesn't look too scary.
Yeah, it felt like it really stalled out after that initial army. He had no follow-up, but I see that he is teching into Husbandry, and I believe I saw Light Cav come in before, so he's probably going to think about producing some of those. Once he gets the raids in on Villese's economy, I mean, Villese is going to have to, what, tech into Halberdier, which will cost resources. Skirmishers won't do so good against the Light Cav. It's just, it's an uphill battle in every way for Villese here.
He doesn't have a single tech towards Halberdiers yet, so that will indeed be quite some investment. Also, fortified walls by Liereyy, something we very rarely see on top level, but I love it.
Yeah, and it's a pretty cheap tech, and it does so much, right? Two times the HP, it's going to be so much slower if Les wants to go for some sort of all-in push to try and damage the economy from Liereyy. And it shifts all the focus over to that right-hand side where Liereyy has all his production buildings.
Also, stone gates there, and yeah, I wouldn't mind if Villese spoiling up some sites as well. It's also so demoralizing, right? You're trying to push in some rams, and Liereyy goes for some more, and just says, I'm happy with taking this to the long game. Small relic advantage for him, market advantage should be on his side, and obviously, map control.
He is losing these Arbalests without doing too much damage. Skirmishers there from Villese, and I don't see the Light Cav anywhere yet, Nilly.
Still taking the last armor, just finished Bloodlines. 41 farmers, did have to go for a lot of those techs, so didn't really set himself up. Okay, has some behind his castle, still holding before attacking.
Yeah, the villager count's getting more and more even here. Villese has managed to hold for the time being, but it feels less like a great defense from him and more like just time in between tech switches for Liereyy as he was building up Light Cav on the left side of the map. Castle at the top for Villese, so he's going to be able to defend that side, but I think Liereyy was thinking about shifting focus anyway.
So now coming in, last armor upgrade, and Liereyy? If he walled both sides and he sees no pressure coming his way, maybe even going for a transport and getting those hussars deep into the economy of Villese might be the play, but no, he favors attacking the left-hand side.
Yeah, you could go for a transport. You could go for something else like cannon galleons as well, Nilly, just to take map control if you're in such a secure position. Using that Saracen market to get the gold for that may be an option as well. Villese taking a good spot here with the Arbalest between his two archer ranges, but the majority of the Hussars will ignore that completely and run directly into Villese's base. Villese trying to do damage on the right side as well, but there's an army there from Liereyy. He's not winning anywhere. He has no advantage in this game.
Yeah, military count is better for him, but against stone walls without any siege, even fortified walls, not going to be too easy to really put that into efficiency. Lots of idle time forced again with the raids here. And Liereyy, yeah, he's just waiting for all his upgrades to finish. Finally gets to the economy that he was looking for.
Yeah, only on 3 TC. He was 2 TC the majority of the way through Castle Age. And he made it work there, so he's just trying to get his villager numbers up to a point where he can make those super, super late game investments like the cannon galleon that we were talking about, or maybe even some siege to counter the army from Villese.
Something that we really wanted to see yesterday, right, with the Celts, Cannon Galleon. He had all the water control there and could have really done something against Liereyy, against Terra, but today, again, not the choice for him. Focuses mainly on land, still even population. The less doing good of prolonging this game. And as I said, if this continues another 20-25 minutes, gold runs out, and then Byzantines really start to shine.
Byzantines are looking good at that point, you're right. Hussars engaging against the Arbalest. I don't think they'll win this fight, but they can dwindle down the numbers to the point where Villese either has to retreat or will die to the reinforcements. Okay, he's retreating right now. Is that his main army? Does he have another army? He's teching into pikemen right now. It's going to take some time to get Halberdier to counter the Hussar. Okay, he has another army on the right-hand side.
40 Arbalest for him on the field, now dropping some, goes more into the 30 numbers. Military production looks relatively okay for Villese, but it's still like he controls like a third of the full land. It's going to be really tricky to deal with all those raids, especially because he couldn't finish those balls.
It feels like Liereyy anticipated this pushback on the right and the attempted pushback on the left from Villese, getting those walls up early, and Villese realizes that even if he kills this army, there's nowhere he can go, there's nowhere he can push into Liereyy's economy, and he probably doesn't have the map control to sustain a late Imperial battle. He taps out, and Liereyy takes game number two. It's now 2-0. Liereyy up against Villese. He's going to have to pull some magic out of the hat for game number three.
And Villese obviously saw the quarterfinals yesterday where Liereyy just toyed so well. Ram attack here, then boat raider attack there. Oh, you cleared out that army, then I will attack you the other side. And Villese was probably fearing that the same would be done to him. Taps out a bit quicker and has to focus on the next three games. The only chance to make it into the finals.
Yeah, we saw him take down Viper, so he certainly has the quality to do that. If we head on to the statistics screen, we will see, you know, a little bit similar military statistics here, Nilly, but the economy is where it really shines. Liereyy getting all the raids in on Villese. Villese never really getting to a stable economy to support his army, and he just seemed like he was a couple minutes behind Liereyy the entire way through this game.
Also had some more eco upgrades, really lovely for him. And if we look at the society there, village account should be better on Liereyy's side. 3-2 relics, so both players setting themselves up for the long game. But Liereyy, what a win. Then some raid there with the knights, did control with the camels. Nice setup for the long game.
I love how he used the water there too. He added a third dock for the fishing ships on the side, and he kept producing them, which means he had less need for farms and he could invest those villagers onto other resources. We saw the gold collected for him almost at 14,000 there, which was quite a bit more than Villese. So great eco management and great pressure from Liereyy once he gets the advantage. And playing safe too, Nilly. I mean, fortified wall, all the outposts around the edges. This is a Liereyy that maybe a couple of years ago we wanted to see, but in 2020 we've definitely seen show up, and he's showing that he can transfer that incredible play into Empire Wars and into Red Bull Wololo 3. Going into map number three, game number three, it's Villese's home map. He has Kawasan. We're expecting to see Huns here again, but Liereyy must know the strategy by now, seeing it from Doubt, seeing it from Villese yesterday. What does he do to counter the Hun Cav Archers?
He did play Franks against Huns yesterday, and honestly, it felt like Hera had a good shot of holding there, right? The pikemen were around, and all the knight numbers were looking pretty solid. Liereyy with an incredible comeback there. With how strong Villese played yesterday and how he took advantages, Liereyy needs to have a better start than yesterday. I think, again, the approach should probably be control the center and fight for the pawns, but that will be a tough task against Huns.
Yeah, we saw, like, I remember, you know, I was lying down, kind of resting my back, and I opened up the stream Nilly, and I saw like 40 or 50 cav archers from Villese against Viper. There was an unstoppable, I think Tristan called it the unstoppable horde of cav archers. And that's what happens when you let the Hun production get out of control. When they have control of a couple pawns and they can shift those villagers that would normally be on farms over to wood, over to gold, and sustain that production, somehow have to stop that. If you're the Frank player, you somehow have to deny the Huns from building up that mass that can one shot, two shot knights. We'll see if Liereyy can do that. Hera didn't go for the cav archers yesterday in this Civ matchup on Kawasan. He went for long swords and he went for some knights of his own. Do you think Liereyy mixes up the Civ pick, or do you think he's just super confident in the Franks here on Kawasan?
Maybe it feels like Tatars is the play, but it just feels very natural to go for Franks there. The big problem, and that's what Villese said yesterday, the typical counter against cav archers are skirmishers, but elite skirmishers, not having the last attack, not having the last defense, you can't really play into Imperial Age with them. If you see a Frank player just goes for elite skirm, sit back, prolong the game, and then you probably should be looking pretty good early in Imperial Age, and Villese certainly smart enough to do that. So I think Mass Knight actually might be the play.
Yeah, Frank Skirm, really not a scalable army for them in Imperial Age, obviously not getting bracers. So if you can force your opponent into that, that's probably a good thing for you. Do you think Villese goes out for the docks early, and do you think Liereyy keeps his scouts around the water to potentially deny those early docks?
It is tricky, right? If your opponent is going for scouts himself with the faster production of Huns, it's not like, okay, I will keep three scouts in the middle and we'll just send two scouts right, two scouts left. No, no, then the Hun player will show up with eight scouts and just kills all your army in the center, right? So it is such an art in Age of Empires to decide, how many scouts do I need to defend? How many scouts can I use to do damage? And how many, like, spare, let's say, low HP scouts can I use to go for scouting and get information on those pawns?
Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of it has to do with luck, too, when you're trying to find dock villagers. Do you show up to the right place at the right time? It's one of the most infuriating things, in my opinion, in Age of Empires to get your dock villager sniped, especially when the dock is 90%+. But here we are into the game. Villese against Liereyy. This is game number three. Villese needs the win. We saw super impressive performance from him with the Huns yesterday against Viper, and Liereyy is opening with a stable. No surprise there. Villese opening with a stable of his own as well.
One villager to the side, and look at that. The spearman is on guard, something we very rarely see used in Age of Empires. Look at how he's following him.
Yep.
It's like T90 co-casting with David co-casting with T90. You're saying, okay, I'm following. Look at that bird. Okay, I'm looking there as well.
Oh, so I'm the one leading the way?
Moving on. Now the second bill here for Villese. He is scaring away the scout, but Liereyy will get a good intel of what's happening.
Yeah, and Liereyy didn't even attempt to look for that dock villager, but he's going to place a dock of his own on the same pond, Nilly. Interesting start from Liereyy. A bit of a switch up from yesterday.
An advantage for Liereyy in that case is that he still kept two villagers on gold. So Villese is limited to two fire galleys in total. Then he needs to send some more villagers over. Liereyy can already go for 4+.
Yeah, and we'll see if Liereyy opts to go for those fire galleys earlier rather than later. Villese trying to defend at home. He's going to successfully do that. He has a couple spearmen of his own and four scouts backing it up. Just needs to avoid taking some extra hits from the spearmen or the scouts, but Liereyy getting some great hits there on the scout as it comes out of the stable.
So tricky to engage there if the opponent has the spearman advantage. And now we can see Villese muscled up his numbers, is now forcing Liereyy to disengage. He goes to another angle. I like how Villese is playing it here quite patiently.
Well, he can play patiently if he assumes that he's going to have the advantage with the fishing eco, but Liereyy has docked the pawn, Nilly, and then opted to not go for any pressure. He's going for fishing ships of his own. So they're going to fish peacefully for a while over there until the other player scouts the enemy dock.
And the major difference to all the Frank Hans games we saw yesterday is simply that the Franks player this time is not going for the center. Didn't send those four villagers out, didn't build the mill. Liereyy with a different approach here.
Well, we saw that actually from Liereyy yesterday. He didn't go out to the center until Castle Age. And then even then, he put a siege workshop just in front of his base and then waited to push out. So Liereyy maybe doesn't want to focus on keeping his villagers safe at the center, doesn't want to allocate army there in defense as Liereyy comes into the gold from Villese, but Villese with more than enough spearmen there to defend. And Villese is looking for opportunities at Liri's base as well, but Liri's going to pick a villager.
And won't lose any HP on his own scouts. Now dives in deep. Counterattack at that side. One villager traded off against the scout.
Both players looking for blood, except when it comes to water, they're just going to add more fish, both of them. Neither one of them scouted the enemy position, so they're going to be perfectly content to sail around while Villese looks for more opportunities in the back of Liri's base, runs into a spearman, but right on top of it, micros away immediately.
Solid macro by Villese there. Defense at home, scout still alive, and both players have to be so happy, like, I forced so much reaction and I still have fish, good for me. Well, you see, Liereyy even scouted a bit at the left-hand side pawn, knows that Villese didn't dock at least close to him.
Yeah, Liereyy is kind of shoring up the holes in the front of his base. He's going to get that down just in time before Villese comes in. There's a wall on the left as well, but Liereyy has his scouts around that area, and he's going to be able to defend the push once again and get those walls up. I think both players, though, Nilly, have to realize that the other is going for water as well based on the scores. Like, that should tell you. I know Liereyy in the interview yesterday didn't even consider water until he looked at the score, and then he was thinking, Hera must have water control because he's 300 or 400 points ahead of me, but the scores are very even now. They have very even militaries on land, and they've done very even damage, so maybe it gives them an indicator.
And scout wars, it sometimes can be tricky. While Villese is taking a good engagement here, forces Liereyy away after getting some hits and even a kill off. Sometimes you just send a villager or a scout on shift click around the world, getting some intel there that was low HP earlier, and the score just increases quite heavily. While we see Fire Galley now attacking, and Liereyy somehow had a hole, and that was one of the more visible ones, I would say.
I thought you said somewhere had a hole, and I was thinking it's pretty obvious where the hole is. As Villese takes out a villager, loses a scout though, and those scouts are pretty weak, so probably not too much damage, but certainly avoidable damage for Liereyy, as we see him taking out a scout on the left hand side. And I'm curious to see whether Liereyy spotted the dock in the other pond from Villese.
I think he did send some scouts around Fire Galley, now attacking there. And look at Liereyy, what is he going for? Five spearmen and now one skirmisher. He prepares his transition, he prepares his defense.
Preparing for the Cav Archers, which looked very, very deadly yesterday, as Villese finally gets his two scouts in the back of Liri's base cleared up. He's got a repair villager over on the water, but won't quite get to the Fire Galley in time, and needs some more production there to defend against the Fire Galley pressure from Liereyy.
His villagers around for the repair, which seems to be more on the even side, but now 2v1 Fire Galley even goes for the warship upgrade.
He's going to take out the fishing ships on the right side. He's also going to take out the fishing ships on the left side, Nilly. He did see that dock earlier from Villese. So Villese's fishing economy, which was one of the things Doubt had going for him, one of the things Villese had going for him yesterday, is going to be non-existent.
This is so good for Liereyy. He's still five workers behind. That will change pretty quickly. And Villese mind-gaming the mind-gamer. Look at that, he was expecting mass knights, goes for mass spearmen into pikemen. Liereyy sitting on skirmishers, only three though. Not the worst counter against pikemen.
Yeah, pretty good counter against pikemen, especially if Liereyy or Villese wants to shift eventually into cav archers. But skirmishers, not the greatest counter against knights, Nilly, which Villese is still producing from two stables. Villese also, I think, sending some villagers forward to the middle as he tries to explore Liereyy's walls here with his pikemen army. See what damage he can do. He's going to see a siege workshop from Liereyy. And yeah, he's going to TC those berries.
Nice control by him. Villese, that's the 2 TC play. Liereyy needs to wall behind this one. Yo. Got a bit hectic there, but Liereyy, apparently a calmer human being than I am. What is his army really against that? Now text into elite skirmisher, needs to wall behind this one. Okay, he buys himself some more time.
It feels tough for Liereyy here if he doesn't successfully wall behind. If at any point these knights get in, could be a huge problem for him as he's not producing from that siege workshop yet, and he has a limited number of skirmishers. So good job prioritizing the wall behind.
So good there. Gets all the houses up. Some of them got really low HP-wise. Now some knights being mixed in. Probably expecting some siege of Villese to snipe those.
And while we were looking over there, Liereyy actually sniped one monk earlier with a knight from Villese, and I think he's going to snipe another one here, Nilly.
Let's see, can he jump into the TC? And no, he can't. Nice pick off again. And Villese probably needs a strategic pause for that.
Yeah, it was actually paused by Liereyy when I look in my game. So Liereyy may be killing that monk and then... I don't know, just kind of settling down, thinking about what he needs to do, or maybe having some technical issues on his side. He unpauses once again. The knights, though, from Villese in on the left-hand side from Liereyy's base, and Liereyy is still camping that gold area. Maybe he didn't realize that Villese got in through that hole?
Skirms are weirdly moving out. He rushes the TC in the back. Could be some dead villagers. TC should go up in time. Those skirmishers not really getting the right task. And well, he did spot it, but oh, a hole. One will down.
Yeah, nice quick walls there initially, and the TC goes up in the end. A villager goes down.
Pikeman for the defense might even save all builds. Loses one, takes the exchange against a knight. Fletching on the way for Villese. Archery range count, 0.
I kind of favor Villese's position here, Nilly. Even though Liereyy got control of those two pawns, Villese already sitting on 2 TCs. Liereyy just got that second TC up, as we saw. And Villese has control of the middle as well, which means he can get the relics.
I like the double pawn for Liereyy. Also, the Siege Workshop already has lots of upgrades on his units. I like that Villese has the center. Yeah, positional advantage, I would say, for Villese. But if we look at pure numbers, probably have to favor Liereyy.
Well, economic advantage for Villese as well, because the fishing ships count towards that villager number from Liereyy. And we can see Villese is still ahead. Losing a couple villagers over here, though.
Okay, no waypoint even, so didn't use that TC at all, except costing 100 food. Scorpion goes down, skirmishers will die as well. Heavy losses on both sides.
Heavy losses indeed, and Liereyy is going to take out the knights in the middle from Villese. He's going to take out that pikeman. Meanwhile, Villese taking out the army from Liereyy coming forward from his base. Another monk goes down for Villese. They haven't gotten much value in terms of conversion so far this game.
Only got one relic as well. You have to ask yourself, maybe building the monastery at the top could have been a better choice. Also, you get some more protection from the TC then. And now the big calf archer switch is coming. 4 archer ranges being dropped.
And this is maybe what Liereyy thought was going to happen at the start of Castle Age. Villese leading with knight pikemen instead, getting his economy rolling, and now switching into cav archers. The relics are certainly going to help with that. Couple knights from Liereyy in through a hole into Villese's economy. Villese clears up the mangonel from him, but has to run away from the pikemen. And how long will it take Villese to notice these knights here? Notices almost immediately. Good job.
two losses there, but no walls there, really. Oh, and he's pulling villagers quite a lot. I don't see a lot of quick wall tries from him when it comes to walling those economies. Something that we see other top players attempting a bit more.
And one thing that Villese is doing as well, he hit a fire galley on that right side pond. You see one little yellow dot there, and he's harassing the fish while they come back to the dock. So Liereyy's going to lose his fishing ships over on the right, which will be nice for Villese. And Villese is trying to mass up cav archers. Has he shown that to Liereyy yet?
Doesn't seem like it, but knights are coming over, maybe finding that. And now the CAs are known for sure.
CA are known. The monks only get one conversion. I think that might be Villese's first conversion of the game, Nilly. He's made about five monks, and I think that might be number one.
Not the prettiest army here by Liereyy. Look at that. Pikemen, skirmishers, some knights, and Liereyy can indeed go for... No, Villese can go for the army that he desires, but skirmish moving forward and finding some good damage against those CA.
And Villese getting a conversion on the knights, saving the Mangonel too. This feels like a much smoother transition here for Villese than it does for Liereyy. Liereyy is making what? Skirmishers, pikemen, rams, mangonels, knights? What did you say before? Not enough butter smoothed over too much bread? I think was
exactly
the quote.
That's what I said. A solid 20 worker lead all of a sudden, because Villese got control over that right-hand side pond, or not really control, but did at least kill the fishing ship. So good on him. It feels like Liereyy's on the timer, although the score is even.
Yeah, it certainly does, and you have to wonder how things would have worked out for Harry yesterday if he went for a similar army composition as Villese is going for right now. Villese has a Mangonel on the hill, could potentially get a shot. Oh, that feels like an easy attack round that he just... He missed there.
Yeah, shot in between the two armies of pike and skirms. Not a lot of army here. Look at the army value. 60% of that for Villese is out of gold. Liereyy goes for the way cheaper investment there. Lots of trash by it.
Yeah, and usually if you're going for the cheaper investment, it means your economy is better behind it. But it's better for Villese currently, and Villese takes a pretty convincing fight there, Nilly, and they're... You know, now there's not too much in defense from Liereyy, which means that Villese could think about pushing into his eco. But meanwhile, at Villese's base, I see some knights over there. There's dead villagers on the stone, more dead villagers under the TC. So Liereyy's trying to get some counter raids in at the same time.
Look at those stuck villagers trying to drop out to the lumber camp, but that won't really happen. Mangonel shots have to be a really good hit for Liereyy, otherwise he can't really deal with that aggression. First Mangonel shot, okay. Only now ballistics by Villese.
You know, I casted that Liereyy Hera game yesterday, and there's so many differences here between that. Same sieves, roughly same style of openings, but Villese going for the cav archers, unlike Hera, and Villese also walling at home, Nilly. So every time Liereyy comes forward with those raids, sure, he's getting one or two villagers, but he's not killing six or seven at a time. It's not making a huge difference to Villese's economy, so... It seems like a better transition here for the Finnish player, and he's on the way to the Imperial Age. Liereyy has not clicked up yet.
Wow, thumping behind the second armor as well. He is getting exactly to the setup that he wants to. Will try to raid that goat. Instant reaction by Liereyy. Good job. But how will Liereyy deal with those CA numbers? It has to be in Castle Age.
Yeah, it feels like you're forced into elite skirmishers here, right? Which is something we said before the game. You never really want to mass up as Franks because they don't get that final upgrade in Imperial Age. He is still producing knights though, and he has light cav teched into. So he's going to try and deal with the monks from Villese, and the cav archers are kind of out of position for this.
Okay, well, that's some nice snipes. Rams will be dealt with, but Liereyy plays this one full Castle Age aggression, so Villese just knows, okay, hold back, don't lose my CA numbers, and once I get Bracer, I should be in a fine spot.
And I see some yellow in Liereyy's base right now, so it looks like Villese has split up a bit. That's a great raid from Villese. Mm.
That's so nice. We'll most likely find four villager kills. Village are still not being pulled back. Some return kills in the center, though, at least some forced idle time. And Villese will just regroup with his Cav Archers. Not too many resources in the bank, though. Can't afford all the upgrades that he desires.
Yeah, Liereyy doing the same thing he did yesterday. He's sending small groups in to raid Villese, though, with some pikemen in defense. And the raids on the left have run into walls. So if Liereyy wants momentum, I think he's going to have to find it maybe a different way. But as I say that, he gets in through the walls on the left. Villese maybe not noticing, and causes a bunch of idle time.
Economy upgrades behind as well, and that castle was denied. So much going on here. That was some good raids for Liereyy. Still 20 population behind, although the last minutes looked so good for him.
Yeah, and I see Liereyy coming forward with some villagers here. What is he going to build? There's a castle foundation. This is deja vu to yesterday, Nilly, as Liereyy sees the foundation for Villese and decides to deny it with a castle of his own. The skirmishers will hold back the Cav Archers long enough for that castle to go up, I think, maybe?
I think so as well, and that's the first one that Liereyy will go for those center berries with Frank, something we have normally seen way earlier. The big advantage for Villese, obviously, he is in. He can win the trap war because Liereyy can't even go for them being stuck in castle.
Yeah, you can tell how distracted Villese is too. He hasn't moved that raiding army. It's been sitting there on the mining camp. As I say it, he moves it, but Liereyy, I think, notices. Maybe he could have done a bit more damage if he was more active with that earlier. Liereyy engaging against the Cav Archers with the skirmishers feels like a fight Villese might not want to take.
Well, that's the old army that he normally wants to keep alive. Village account relatively even. What can Liereyy do to even solidify his position in the center a bit more? Is pet arts an option? Are ramps an option? Or does he just have to accept that he will lose the center eventually and needs to keep raiding?
You're going to lose that treb war with that position. You're not even up to the Imperial Age yet. You're going to lose it for sure. And with a TC in front, with the Siege Workshop in front, with the castle position, it feels like petards and rams are just a no-go.
Probably the way too long, but those Cav Archers will see some losses. Skirms will be dealt with. Liereyy with some micro there, being really annoying.
Yeah, the thing Villese needs to... He needs to lock down his base somehow. He did it at the beginning, but now he's overchopping woodlines, which means knights can get in. He can't constantly have his Cav Archer army coming back from the middle to defend against these knights. Liereyy will just slowly whittle down his economy, and Villese isn't doing any damage to the economy from Liereyy. So either produce some of your own knights and go for some raids if you're in Villese's shoes, kind of throw that back in Liereyy's face, or wall up, or make the Halberdier transition.
Decides to go for the raid there. TCs of Villese obviously pretty strong with Bracer and Chemistry there, lots of damage output. And we only now see Liereyy finishing the armor upgrade for his elite skirmishers. That's why you traded off so poorly.
Yeah, it felt like they maybe should have done better there against the Cav Archers. Now Villese has cleared up that raid. He's going to head back to the middle with his Cav Archers, and he's adding stables. He's adding a ton of stables, Nilly. I really like that decision from Villese.
He did see the Cavalier attack earlier, so he knows exactly what he wants to go for. Still 25 villagers onto gold, and Liereyy, he's doing an impeccable job of raiding over and over again. Found over 60 villager kills this game already, but what's the answer to Cavaliers?
Exactly, that's what I was thinking, especially if Villese goes for something similar on Liereyy's economy and sneaks in through the holes. Liereyy trying to find some more damage on the woodline, pikemen coming over though, so maybe it will be stalled out, and his attention is going to have to be focused on the middle now. The Cav Archers are coming forward, they have tread support. Super excited about that one. Maybe he'll try tributing some resources to Villese to get him off the front of his base. Or maybe he's thinking about the points. I don't know. It seems a little bit early for me, Nilly.
The upgrade to get more resources if you want to give some resources to your teammate was research there, but cancelled instantly after that. Just a misclick on the last funny moment there, at least to me. Liereyy, pop 140, the last 160, and still one HI had military value double for our finish point.
But his military is constantly divided between these raids, and Liereyy actually building buildings on the right-hand side, stables for more production for the raids, and sending knights in on the left. Villese clearing up the remaining villagers from Liereyy in that middle position. I'm surprised they survived that long, to be honest. But he's going to start pushing into Liereyy's main base now, and the raids have worked for Liereyy so far. He needs something substantial to actually kill the main army from Villese, and he doesn't have it at the moment.
Trying to dwindle down with his own skirmishers, but look at those numbers. 45 cav archers against 13 skirmishers. Dave, is that going to work?
I'm going to go with a no, but maybe we can go with wait and see. No, they're not going to work. And the raids from Liereyy, he sent quite a few knights into the back, but Villese, he's had enough of this, Nilly. He has had enough. He's got quite a few pikemen wandering around behind there and coming forward with some villagers too. I think he's placing a castle on that front hill in front of Liereyy's economy. This seems like a victory for Finland here. Or Finland, Villese, Finnish player, whatever we want to call him.
For the whole country of Finland, because we know every single one is watching. Villese puts himself on the scoreboard here in the semi-finals. Only two more wins for him to make the final appearance.
And once again, just proving that cav archers work in certain situations. Huns work against Franks on this map. He went out for the water early. He contested the water with Liereyy. Liereyy actually ended up taking over control, but Villese adding TCs earlier probably had the better army composition, and the raids from Liereyy just couldn't get enough done, and he had nothing to stop the main force from Villese pushing into his base. Villese takes the win. It is now 2-1 for Liereyy.
Really well played there by Villese to allow himself the comeback when it comes to the economy control, because Liereyy was having a nice setup with the pawns, but Villese, it's just so easy, right, with Hans to continue booming. And well, as we mentioned several times, cav archers just feel so strong if you can control the game.
Yeah, if you can't keep their numbers down early, they get to a point where it's almost unstoppable, especially with the weak Frank skirmishers. Going to the statistics now, the military count will be firmly in Villese's advantage, and I'm pretty sure like 70 of those units killed from Liereyy were just villagers, and most of the units killed from Villese were military. You can see the army count, 84 at the end of the game, so really, really tough to stop if you're in Leary's shoes. Looking at the economy, Liereyy, I predict, will have... Yep, he has more food collected because of those fishing ships. But it didn't really help him in the end there.
Yeah. Well, the elite skirmishers simply needed to do more. And they needed to deal better with that cav archer number. But lacking the armor upgrade there really hurt them. CA could just take a better fight than they should have gotten.
Yeah, and the villager count was even. That's always nice to see. Relic gold in advantage for Villese. And then the timeline, you can see it was pretty even throughout most of Villese's castle age. And then near the end, he started peaking and started taking control. His military count really, really spiking there, especially at the end game. So, game number four. Villese needs a win to stay in this set. Liereyy is moving on to his home map. What home map do you expect, and what civ selection do you expect to see, Nilly?
We will see winged, very aggressive choice there for sure. Short distance, we feel like Bulgarians could be a really strong one. Then Tatar play for her boob feels likely. On the other side, Slavs are still an option. Franks there on the other side taken away. So it feels like I say Malians for Winged and Slavs for her boob on the left side.
And your theory is correct here, Nili. I'm in the spectator countdown, roughly a minute until this game number four begins, and I see that Liereyy has gone for the Bulgarians once again on Winged, and Villese has gone for the Malians. So we'll see if Liereyy decides to go for something like he did yesterday with the, if I remember correctly, he went for men-at-arm pressure against Hera. He just couldn't quite get the damage done. Hera managed to push it back, and that was the shortest game of the set.
Yeah, that was some nice defense there for sure. Could you quickly remind me, what was the villager count last game?
118.
For whom? For Liereyy?
Both.
So the Finnish player didn't have any less? And the Austrian player?
I love these awkward moments, Nili. I saw that coming from so far away, and then I have to sit through it, and then you expect me to react to it. So I feel like the best way to punish you is to not react at all to your
But now I know your strategy.
Yeah, but how do you counter it? What's the counterplay to that?
Laugh there is none. Too much. Pretend that I was funny. That's like, then I'm really confused.
I thought that was my job. All right, we're going into game number four here. The map is Winged. Liereyy is going to be playing as the Bulgarians, and we'll open with archers, and Villese will be playing as the Malians. And I already see from the minimap there, Nili, Villese is taking no chances. He's going for some walls immediately.
So archer defense there against the man-at-arm opening from Liereyy. Lots of walls. Remember, guys, he will play with the cube mod, seeing those trees as small green boxes. Shouldn't really have as many holes as the human beings that we would be.
Yeah, Liri's looking for some damage. Still with the man-at-arms, so he thinks it works. It certainly will if you manage to get into the eco, but it's whether you can get in there. And I see Villese making some pre-walls here. He's going to be safe on his woodline at the front for the time being, but Liereyy coming forward with a skirmisher now, which will be able to raid those villagers over the trees.
Well, let's see. One skirmisher, most of the time, not the most annoying thing ever. Villese needs to make something happen in addition to his archers eventually, though. And now we see him rushing out of stable.
Yeah, stable's a good choice here against the skirmishers that he sees. The men-at-arms kind of have a time window to do damage until you get the archer numbers up that can counter them. So Liereyy is looping around, looking for the opportunities to do that damage. And I see a dot on the water as well. So it looks like Villese is going for a dock and is going to build up the fishing economy behind this.
Liereyy already two villagers idle time there. So he did cut some corners, wants to go for some aggression. That one villager is very confused though.
I think maybe she ran all the way around trying to chop a tree. She seems lost. And the man-at-arm isn't going to help her out at all. He's going to take her down. So one villager kill there for Liereyy. And Villese, interesting strategy here. He sees the army from Liereyy over on his berries. He's opting not to attack that. He's going to loop around to the front, take out the skirmishers, and then maybe try and hit the economy at home for Liereyy.
Good job there, Spearman against that. Only one archer, one man-at-arm. I think Villese can take that fight. Looks really good for him here, but Skirm's ready to do some counter damage.
Yeah, it feels like you don't even... Yeah, the scout already killed an archer. It's probably going to kill another one. It felt like you didn't even need to bring the archers close to that battle, right? The scouts could have probably handled it on their own, but he did, and he's going to lose all of his archer numbers. And this is a position you never want to be in against Liereyy, where he wins the initial engagements, keeps up the production, and you're just on the back foot for the entire game.
Just compare that to the approach that Hera had yesterday. He just was so patient with the small buildings, the small walls, and the control, then kept his economy running and stable a bit earlier for the defense. Now so many villages exposed here at the front. Still not dying, but getting arrested.
Do you think it's possible for Villese to not fight back this army, to just kind of delay, build up scouts, and then send them to Liri's economy to try and counter this? Because it feels like you can't win the fight at home, but you might be able to do some damage abroad.
He has two scouts right now, right? And something going on for him is that he
has... Oh, no!
But now they're pushing in. Oh, God, this was really ugly for him. Those villagers are exposed now.
Yeah, I think the archers opened the gate as they were retreating. The archers both died, and they let the scouts into the economy. So now Villese is off gold. He's off the wood. The scouts can potentially harass the farms. It's not looking good for the Finnish player.
Uh-oh, needs to run all those villagers to the left-hand side, another lumber camp. Luckily for him, a bit cheaper, but how is the army production going to look here? 7 against 14 military. Okay, scouts will do quite fine here. Running under the TC, spearmen there with the defense. Okay, this was really good for Villese to allow himself into a comeback.
Yeah, that was a really great recovery from him. He saved most of his villagers, got them safe, walled up to the TC, garrisoned it in time to do damage to the scouts, and looped around with his own scouts to kill the skirmisher and archer numbers from Liereyy. So not quite dead yet. Still in this game. We'll see what he can do. Looping around here, but a spearman now from Liereyy.
Uh-oh, and a spearman is the perfect counter to everything that Villese has. He has only two archers there, not really massing up. Another spearman is getting sniped. KD, really brutal here, 17 to 12. Now another attack, those berries really exposed. Do you think Villese needed a defensive tower?
Well, he's going for one on the wood line. He realizes that's the most exposed area of his eco. That wood line is a maze. The villagers trying to find their way through, but the scouts now from Liereyy coming in. Gonna take out the scouts from Villese immediately. And then maybe go over and focus on the villagers building the tower.
Let's see, that will be some dead villagers. Those scouts obviously having upgrades on them, namely all of them, and we'll find so many villagers killed here. It's looking rough for Villese.
Yeah, the villager count, the worker count is in favor for him, but that's because he's been spending all his wood to invest on water, so he does have 5 fishing ships working currently. So villager count not really indicative of how it actually is at this moment, and Liereyy is constantly hanging out near Villese's gold, constantly running around that farming area, and Villese's woodline does not look pretty nearly.
Indeed, it does not, and Liereyy plays completely open at home. Just look at the column at the very right. That's the idle time for all the villagers combined, and you simply see how much Villese had to run, and that's why you see so many more resources for Liereyy, and he put it in military.
Yeah, and Liereyy's pressuring the south, he's pressuring the north. I saw Villese running across with some scouts seeking to do damage, but it's 3 scouts for Villese looking to raid and like 10 scouts from Liereyy with archers supporting. He's going to kill villagers on the woodline. I think Liereyy has advanced to the next round, but we'll see if Villese has any solutions to this pressure. Yeah, he's going to call it.
Wow. That was a convincing one, and Liereyy just looked so sharp there. The man-at-arms opening followed up by so much aggression. Liereyy, the defending champion of Red Bull Wololo 2, will have another finals appearance.
Yeah, very convincing performance from him. I mean, wow, did Villese even win a single engagement that game? Even when he came out to kill the archers and the skirmishers, he got a lot of hits from the scouts from Liereyy. He tried to take the fight at the front with his own scouts and archers. He lost his archer numbers for free. Liereyy just showing his strengths and showing his ability to take those early fights and just snowball it into victory, especially when you're so close on a map like Wing, the fishing ships. The superior worker number just couldn't get it done for Villese. Good job from him though, making it to the semifinals. I think no one would have predicted him to be here. Liereyy, though, going forward to face whoever comes out of our second semifinal, which is coming up next.
Will be ACM versus Stout. Let's take a look at the statistics here. Should be pure dominance for Liereyy, and Bulgarians played out so nicely with the cheaper upgrades there, did get all the upgrades for his scouts that early on, men at arm opening, had all the pressure going for himself. KD 32 to 17, and largest army 23 to 9. Villese was never able to really get to the numbers. Defensive tower earlier, something that I probably would have liked to see.
Yeah, it felt like as soon as Villese got his archer numbers whittled down by the skirmishers and the scout from Liereyy, he just could never recover from that position. You need those archers alive, especially if you're playing a defensive strategy like he did. Liereyy with the eco advantage, even with more food, consistently more food than Villese, even with the five fishing ships.
Well, it was like five farmers for Villese for a very long time, pushed away from the berries. And you see like how little dark yellow there is. He could never get a strong force for himself.
Yeah, and that's not what you want against Liereyy. The army advantage was, I think at the end, 23 to 9, like we saw on the military statistics screen. So Liereyy with a convincing performance against Villese. Villese trying to hang in there, getting a great victory on Kawasan, once again proving that cav archers are a thing in certain circumstances, but couldn't carry the momentum through to Winged to take that second game. Now, I think we have an interview with Liereyy upcoming. I don't know how much time he needs, but I believe we're bringing...
Yeah, he will be joining any second, indeed, and you will come back for the third and fourth part, the StarCraft 2 part and the finals later on. Thank you so much, Dave. You will take a short break, and please tell me that joke with the Villese. That was hilarious, right?
I'm going to stick to my strategy. I'm not going to react to that. I will say, though, before the StarCraft video, just remember, chat, if you're a StarCraft pro, I know nothing about that game. Fortunately, I did have a procaster with me to hold my hand through the experience. So I hope you enjoy that. And I will see you guys later. Enjoy the interview with Liereyy and enjoy the second semifinal. This should be amazing.
And I can say hello to Mr. Liereyy. Congratulations. You did win Red Bull Wololo 2 and you are back in the finals. What are your thoughts? What are your feelings?
Feeling good, man. What can I say? Pretty happy.
We did have a very similar series with similar matchups like yesterday, I have to say. After beating Hera yesterday, where would you rank your confidence rating going into today?
I was pretty confident. I kind of didn't do the mistakes I did yesterday in my games. I kind of improvised a bit from my strategies, kind of adapted a bit as well, and I kind of prepared against him. I knew it would be Kawasan. I wanted to try something there, but it didn't really work out that well. But back to your confidence level, I do feel pretty confident, and yeah, I'm pretty happy with my performance today.
Yeah, and rightfully so. Villese looked incredibly strong yesterday, and you had some convincing performances starting off in Arabia. Yesterday, you played Ethiopians against the Aztecs of Hera. He did have the same opening. What did you change in your approach to increase your winning chances there?
I don't want to go into detail too much, but I kind of mixed up my army a bit, did some adaption, and I knew that in late game I would win, so I didn't even have to make so much damage, but obviously any free damage is more than welcome. And I was kind of pretty confident about the matchup. I kind of knew that Ethiopians should win over Aztecs, in my opinion at least, and yesterday I kind of knew how Aztecs would win. And then I kind of adapted and looked at the replay again and figured it out. So.
Okay. And what did you figure out?
I want to keep that for the finals, you know? Maybe Doubt is listening. You never know. Or ACM.
Okay.
We don't know.
Okay. Well, I respect that. And then we went into Curtailed. You have a different approach to Villese. He is opening Fire Galley. You are opening with Galleys. What do you think? Why does that play out so differently?
I do think Galleys should win water. But then again, there's so much action on the land as well. Especially when he sneaks around the Ville like he did and sends some knights to my eco. So then kind of gets tricky to micro on water, because you obviously have to hit and run for the galleys to work. And then it kind of gets tricky and easier for him to play. But I think if you play it right, I feel like galleys should be better.
Do you think it makes a difference if you play Samram from Asia compared to Europe, how well you can micro the galleys?
Yeah, it definitely felt a bit more smooth, although there weren't really any galley fights like yesterday, right? Even fire galleys, all I have to do is hit and run. I don't have to like split or anything. So it didn't matter that much, but there's definitely a difference between Asia and Europe ping.
And then you won the water, but village account was relatively even after we saw all the night raids. You were very aggressive over and over again, and then you went into the fortified wards. Why was that?
Well, I saw his push from the left side coming, right? And I was pushing on the right side, and he was pushing from the left side, and I knew that he didn't have too much army, because he reached in later than me, and I didn't really see any military buildings in the right side, so I decided to push in from the right and just stonewall from the left, so he takes more damage than me, and then I can prepare my Hussar switch and take it from there.
Okay. Well, and your Hussar switch indeed came in, did some damage, forced him to GG, then you were up 2-0. And then you said you expected him to pick Kavasan, expected him to play Hans, wanted to trade something different. What was that?
Well, the skirm switch, right? Didn't work out as planned. Like, I have an idea why it didn't work. I don't want to mention it, but...
More upgrade.
We might... That helps as well, true. But I might... I'm not sure if I'll try it again in final. We'll see, I guess.
Okay. Oh boy, I'm so excited to listen to another interview if we get it from you. That would be really sweet. And then Bulgarians, your choice on Winged. You did play the same opening against Terra yesterday. What was your approach? What did you change? Because this time it looked more convincing.
I changed something in my build. Stable earlier and a bit more aggression yesterday. And also Herald's last yesterday, right? Villese had Slavs in the draft as well, but I was pretty sure he was going to pick Mayans or Malians, because he kind of needs Slavs for Haboob to be able to win. So I felt pretty confident going into the matchup. And, well, Hera defended like godlike yesterday, so I think it was more like him playing well rather than me messing up. And I think he kind of went for fish. I didn't even see. I think he went for fish because he didn't have too much army on land. Mm-hmm. And I kind of could snowball from there and take it on the land, so.
Yeah, you forced a lot of aggression. He did indeed have fish, but had to run villagers over and over again. And, well, then that was the 3-1 for you. Up next, you will face either Doubt or ACCM. Any wishes?
I think Doubt against me looks better, or, like, looks a bit... Well, it looks better on paper, but I don't mind either, honestly. I think both have performed great so far, and either can do it from them.
Okay, and we will have the second semi-final up next. You will have a solid rest over, I would just roughly say, 2 hours. How are those 2 hours looking for you?
Well, I'm going to watch the games and see what my opponents do, and maybe change some of my plans.
Change some of your plans. Okay, interesting to see that. Liereyy, good rest for you. Well played. Excited to see you in the finals with another strong performance. I'm pretty sure about that. Thank you so much and good luck later on.
Thank you.
Then we will jump into the highlights of this first semifinal, and then we'll be back with Doubt versus ACCM, cast by me and T90, and... this will actually be live. See you then. Por favor, monsieur et madame, allez à la Twitch stream de Twitch España, por favor.
That's exactly what I was hoping would happen.
It's international, right?
Just wanted a few extra units to get in the way. Look at this. Look at this, Nilly. Those archers. He saved them for so long. Got some great hits on the eagles. And you know, the spearmen, the gate is going to go down extremely fast. The eagles are inactive in a market wall attempted, but Leary's in. And this is big time trouble for Villese, not the start he wanted. Yeah, he's got to get the crossbows in the right position and the knights in front. He's trying to get them up on the hill. The knights are engaging. There's monks behind though, Nilly.
Not choice there, but we don't put the monks no more face on them. But the army was simply good enough. Liereyy with that beautiful hill for the crossbows. So close to the fight, but still doing some return favor while there's so much going on the water. Oh god, this is triple pronged action now.
Yeah, Villese's base looks a lot more secure though than Liereyy's. Liereyy's was very open as Villese comes in with those fire ships. And Villese quick walling around the TC. He already pre-walled his wood line.